Well, good morning, Church First Baptist Church family. I come to you today, and we're going to do a unique service. It's going to be a lot of singing and a lot of scripture reading and a lot of prayer, and it's all going to be focusing on God's faithfulness. And so, as we begin, this week marks the beginning of Pentecost, or the week of Pentecost. In the Christian tradition, we celebrate this week because it represents God's Spirit breaking into humanity and pouring upon his people. And in both the Greek and the Hebrew, the word for spirit also means breath, as in I can't breathe, or as in I'm having a hard time breathing, or I am full of breath. And so the prayer for us this morning is that may God's Spirit break into our world and give us breath. For those who need breath for financial disparity from this coronavirus, may you give us breath in this time. For those of us who are finding injustice, God, may you give us breath. For those of us who are struggling with illness and this COVID takes away breath, may you give us breath. And for those of us who can breathe good and they can breathe just fine, may the Spirit give us a different breath, a breath to cry out to a holy and perfect God. Would you please join me as we celebrate and remember and long for God's faithfulness.
Psalm 124. If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, let Israel now say, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side when people rose up against us, then they would have swallowed us up alive when their anger was kindled against us. Then the flood would have swept us away, the torrent would have gone over us. Then over us would have gone the raging waters. Blessed be the Lord who has not given us his prey to their teeth. We have escaped like a bird from the snare of the fowlers. The snare is broken and we have escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth.
Well, hey everyone, we're talking about God's faithfulness today. And we're going to be celebrating that through singing of song and reciting scripture together. And I thought I'd just offer a few words on God's faithfulness. 2 Timothy 2:13 says it this way: if we are unfaithful, God remains faithful. Psalm 36:5 says, your steadfast love, O Lord, extends to the heavens, your faithfulness to the skies. It's hard to think of someone who's always faithful in all things. We live in a broken world, and we live in a world full of people who are always looking out for them selves, and regardless of what they say or do, promises are broken, lines are crossed, people fall short. That's what I would call the human condition. But even in a world that is faithless, God remains faithful. And here's the big idea for us this morning. Being faithful is not something God does. Being faithful is who God is. Faithfulness is essential. It's essential to his being. Without it, he would not be God. And so, in fact, for him to be unfaithful would actually go against his very own nature. And so I come to you this morning saying, perhaps some of you are dealing with some pretty heavy things right now, and it feels like God is not being faithful. You can't feel him. You can't sense him. You can't feel his working in your life. It just doesn't feel like his presence is upon you. But as the Gospel of John tells us that, listen, God never said that we would not see trouble or pain or frustrating situations, but the great promise is that he will be with us and he is faithful in all of those things. And in fact, Romans 8:28 says that God is working all of those things out for our good. And I hope that you can see that. I hope that you have experiences of that. And I hope that you can feel that and embrace that even today. He is working. It may not be immediate and it may not be visible, but he is working. He is always working. And beloved, it is always for our good for those of us who are in Christ. And so if your situation is not good, another big idea, it's not over yet. Cling to God's promises. Call on him because he is the one who is faithful. And so we're going to be taking the opportunity to reflect on his faithfulness this morning through scripture and prayer. And I'm so excited to do this unique service with you. I hope that you will call upon the one who is faithful. Blessings to you all.
God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam and the mountains quake with their surging. Selah. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. God is within her. She will not fall. God will help her at break of day. Nations are in uproar. Kingdoms fall. He lifts his voice. The earth melts. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Selah. Come and see the works of the Lord, the desolations he has brought on the earth. He makes wars cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Selah.
All for participating in this wonderful service. Thank you, Kathy and Dustin and the whole team for helping out and everyone who participated. We're so thankful for each and every one of you. As we leave this place, may we be forever changed, that we may look more like Jesus, and may we pursue Jesus with all that we are. Go in peace, everyone.
I've had many tears and sorrows. I've had questions for tomorrow. There's been times I didn't know right from wrong. But in every situation, God gave blessed consolation, that my trials come to only make me strong. Through it all, through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God. Through it all, thank him for the valleys. I thank him for the storms he brought me through. for if I never had a problem, I wouldn't know that he could solve them. I never know what faith in God can do. Through it all, I've learned to trust in God through it all.